cam hooks.
Hey, Petey, can you hand me my leg?
I'm Jarem Frye. Lost my leg to bone cancer when I was 14 years old.
I'm Pete Davis. So I was born without an arm. People call me One Arm Pete.
I'm Craig DeMartino. I lost my leg in 2003 after a 100-foot ground fall climbing in Colorado.
Yeah, the climbers have a climber call. And you know, the Gimp Monkeys, we've got our own call. And you know, we're gonna start hearing it all over the place now. We're gonna have Gimp Monkeys all over the place. So Craig, Jarem, and I all met in 2006 at the Extremity Games, which is like the X Games for amputees. So we were all there in the climbing competition, and one of us threw out the idea to do, you know, an all-disabled ascent of El Cap.
The three of us are all climbers first, and then second, we're disabled. And so if climber is what you are, one of the best things you can do as a climber is climb El Cap. So last year I came out with Jarem Frye thinking we would do Lurking Fear.
My leg wasn't fitting very well, and then my leg just fell off.
In the list of reasons to bail, that's probably a pretty good one, and that's what we did. We ended up bailing right then.
You know, being honest about it, I think like a lot of people do, I found an excuse and I took it, and it just ate at me the whole year. I was like, I failed at that. I can't fail. I don't fail.
It's been bugging me for 2 years. I mean, it's just, you know, you keep thinking, okay, I'm not going to obsess on it, but you wake up every morning and you're like, shit, we didn't get it done.
This year, there were just no excuses. We were making it to the top.
We're not going to raise awareness. We're not going to, for the cause of disabled people, to show people anything. We were just going because we all like to climb, and it's just one of the raddest places to climb.
Pete is a character. You know, it's amazing seeing what he can do with one arm. I mean, the guy functions like an octopus.
I'm kind of almost ambidextrous, if you will. Like, I can wear the prosthetic or I can take it off. Usually I'm better without it. Put a happy face on, get the right attitude, you know, and it's no big deal, man. You know, even when I was scared on lead, I could take a look around and be like, man, I'm on El Cap, I'm living large. There's definitely no feeling like riding the high seas of granite, being high on the Capitan. Everything's difficult on the wall. Going to the bathroom, drinking water, eating food. I mean, seriously, it's so hard just to get your food out of the haul bag. It changes your perception of what you can do, you know, what really is difficult and what is not. You don't sweat the small stuff after you deal with a wall like this.
Craig is patient, mature, wise. He's the one-legged Gandhi. Craig is the one-legged Gandhi of big wall climbing.
Our system and the world around us, they make it really easy for you to be disabled. The expectation goes down, and you can immediately take that excuse and go, well, you know what, I'm jacked up now, I can't do anything. But then you've let that situation win. And I didn't want my kids to see me do that. I didn't want my wife to see me do that. I didn't want to be that person who like sat on the couch. Well, I used to be a climber, I used to be the, I didn't want to do that. I mean, I wasn't thinking I'm going to go climb El Cap again, but I was thinking, I think I want to go climb again. And that's a decision. You have to make that choice and say, at the end of the day, I didn't want my disability to become an excuse for me not to follow what I was passionate about.
Jarem is our Mormon juggernaut, and he's definitely an inspiration because, you know, he's got it a little tougher than Craig and I. I'm sure he got worked pretty good, but never backed down, and he was doggedly determined.
We're limited by our beliefs. I was limited by my beliefs last year, And this year, 80 feet up, I had that struggle. I didn't get a chance to train for it this time, and I was just like burning. I was like, I can't do 1,600 feet, 2,000 feet. And that was my time to bail or go. And I just decided I was going to the top, no matter what. I was not gonna quit.
It's all about attitude, and it's all about perception. What do you really perceive as hard? I feel like having one arm, it's a pretty minor inconvenience, really. And that's just my perception. And so that's allowed me to do a lot of things in life and not hold me back. The right attitude and one arm will beat the wrong attitude and two arms every time.
I think that everyone has a disability of some kind. You know, it's mental, it's physical, but they have stuff going on. So if something holds you back, that's your disability, but you gotta own it and say, okay, but I'm gonna use it to move forward instead of letting it hold me back.
Finishing up the last pitch, I mentally was kind of over it, but there was never a point where I thought that we weren't gonna do this. I knew that we were gonna get to the top. It took us 4 nights, 5 days, not the speed ascent, but slow and steady wins the race. And this being the first all-disabled ascent, I expected that, but we got it done, and then topping out felt great.
I can't even express how cool it was to pull up over that mantle and stand up on top with them, because you're just like, holy crap, man, we just got that done.
I have never been this worked in my entire life. Most painful, most difficult, most incredible thing I've ever done.
I think everyone is capable of great things, and I think everyone is capable of making excuses. But at the end of the day, I can't settle for just making excuses.